life.
Excited? My name is David Rosenstein. I'm going to be your host for today's show. I hope you're excited to have a great show. Well, I'm representing the Society of Young Magicians Assembly number 69, and we are here to perform an incredible show. Are you ready? All right, that's what I like to hear. Our first performer is just 8 years old, and he just flew in from New Jersey. Now, he enjoys playing the piano and caring for his two pet rats, who, before his last act, were actually human assistants. So, don't be afraid, but ladies and gentlemen, please put your hands together for our first performer, David Saperstein.
I love fishing, but unfortunately in New York, there's not many places to go fishing. So that's why I bring my own fishing hole. And ladies and gentlemen, for my first trick, I will change myself into a fisherman. Okay. Oh, wait, no. Does anyone in bait? No one? Wait, this is Manhattan, New York, right? No one is bait? One time I went ice fishing, I drilled a hole, and this loud booming voice said, "There are no fish there." So I went about 10 feet, drilled another hole. The voice said again, "There are no fish there." God, is that you? No, I own the rink. Fishing, I couldn't catch anything. The guy next to me caught like I couldn't even count how many fish. So I asked him, "What's your secret?" He said, "Rain, warm, warm." What? Rain, warm, warm. What? Keep the worms warm. Longer than I remember. Mm-hmm. it's a sea monkey. I used to work with live animals, but there was an incident. So now they only let me use stuffed monkeys and wooden rabbits. Okay, I've got a white bunny here. He's our president, lives in the White House. And a black bunny. We all know where he lives. I am going to make them switch places. But after I move this over there and move this over there, now they'll switch places. Abracadabra, alakazam, presto change-o. Okay. The black one is in here, and the white one is in here. Now I'm going to make them switch back. First, you put this on here. You put this on here. You move this over here. Then you just move that over there. And then, abracadabra, presto, change-o, switch! It should eventually switch back to here.
No. Turn it around.
Turn them around? Okay.
They're on different sides.
No.
I'm turning them around. The other side? The other side? The back? The back? This is the back.
Turn the bunnies around.
The back of the rabbits. The back of the rabbits.
Turn the rabbits around. It's white on the black rabbit.
Okay. You think you're so smart. You just try to figure out how my trick works and then just ruin it on television. You just barge into my life and just try to ruin the trick I've been practicing for years. So thank you.
I can honestly say that was certainly unexpected, and I can see why they don't let him deal with regular live animals anymore. I'd like to try an experiment with you. You sitting on the other side of the television screen. I'm actually going to try a trick, and I'm going to try and read your mind through the screen. I know it may not be possible, it may not look possible, but I can assure you it is. You see, I have a prediction on this card. I want you to think of a number, 1 to 1,000. Have you done so? Say it out loud, think it in your head, whatever, I can't hear you. I'm getting a number. I'm getting a number. Is your number? I got it. Is your number 431? No? No, it wasn't? Well, then I was exactly right. Right on. All right. This next performer, he's actually 18 years old, he lives in Manhattan, and recently he participated in a program called Magic Without Borders, where he traveled recently to India to do magic for people who normally don't see it. He's a wonderful kid, and he's a previous president of the Society of Young Magicians. Please put your hands together for the wonderful Alexander Posner. Take it away.
A deck of cards. So I think we're going to try a card trick. And I need a volunteer. Will you help me out?
Sure.
What's your name?
Tate.
Give him a round of applause, everyone. Thank you so much for helping me out.
Try a bit of a prediction. I'm going to see if I can figure out what's going on before it actually happens. So I don't actually have a piece of paper, but I'll just use this receipt. Make a prediction. Wonderful. We're going to take the box, put the prediction right there. So we have a deck of cards. What I'd just like you to do is say stop.
Stop.
Right there? Yes? Okay, take the card, look at it. Show it to everyone. Make sure everyone can see. Yes, good. Wonderful. I'd like you to take the card and just return it to the deck. Excellent. So you have the card locked into your mind. All of you at home also know the card. And we have here a prediction that has been in full view the entire time. Right? Right on the edge of this table. So we remove the card box. And for the first time, nice and loud, tell me the card you selected.
Four of diamonds.
The four of... the six of... Sure was the four of diamonds. Okay, I have an idea. Just coming up with ideas left and right here, trying to improvise a little. Let's see if we take this receipt, get this nice and close so everyone can see. Wonderful. Can actually see that if you burn the receipt, the four of diamonds appears right on the receipt. That was your card? That was your card. Thank you so much, everyone. Tate, thanks so much for helping me out. Have a great day, everyone.
I know that I better start shopping at CVS more. That was truly amazing. This next performer, he's 15 years old, just like me. He's been in the SYM for three full years now, and this is his third time performing at Kids Zone. As well as magic, you'll soon learn he loves to ski. Please put your hands together for the amazing, mystical Robert Dorfman.
And one of my favorite things to do besides magic is skiing, and specifically ski racing. Now, in a ski race, there are a lot of racers, but only the top three racers are awarded medals. The first medal awarded is the bronze medal, and this medal is awarded to the third place racer. The medal awarded next, after the third place medal is awarded, is the silver medal, given to the second place racer. And the third medal awarded is the gold medal, given to the winner of the race. Now, the truth is, after a race is finished, no one really cares about that third place racer. In fact, no one cares either about that second place racer. The only racer that they care about is the winner of the race. Now, me myself, in my ski racing career, I have only ever won silver medals. I just wasn't as quick and agile as the other racers as they made their way to the finish. But as I've improved, I've gotten bigger and I've gotten stronger. I've started to win more and more silver medals. But as I improve, I have to keep one thing in mind. I can't let myself become too big-headed. Now, this past season was actually my best season yet. And the reason for that was I won my very own gold medal. Thank you guys very much. I'm Robert, and I hope you enjoy the rest of the show.
Now, that was truly incredible. Thank you, Robert. I know Robert likes to ski in his free time. I like to do something a little different, something that most people don't do. I have this weird tendency. I eat glue. I don't eat it. I don't swallow it. But I do put it in my mouth long enough just for the effects to take place. Watch.
There are two lips. But
just like that. Thank goodness Elmer's is non-toxic. Now, our next performer, she's 9 years old. She's in the third grade in Chapin School. And aside from magic, she loves swimming, reading, and pogo sticking, something I was never coordinated enough to do. So everyone, please put your hands together for the amazing Kika.
Magic words. I have a
flowers? You can't eat flowers. There's always a second chance. Well, let's see. The bag is still empty. Let's use another magic word. Abracadabra, presto. I feel something in here. Please say it's a hamburger. Please say it's a hamburger. Tuna would be better, but flowers, not again. I really should have done better in visiting grade school. Well, if they're all flowers, I hope the next one is at least cauliflower. Does not feel very good. And it does not taste very good. I'm hungry. I guess this is a reminder that I'm going to the flower show this afternoon. I guess I have to wait for later for lunch. I'm finally at the flower show. Let's see. I brought a cloth along. Well, four cloths to be precise. One yellow, one green, one red, and one blue. They look a little bit little. Let's see. Maybe if I stuff them into my hand, do a magic word like abracadabra rotten tomato cans, and they'll turn into one piece. That's strange. There's no flowers in the flower pots. Guess this wand can help me make a flower. Kind of old. Abracadabra, presto. Let's try another magic word. Abracadabra. Abracadabra, rotten tomato cans.
Well, that was, I think that kind of makes me want to go to the flower show now that I think about it. Now that was definitely something. Speaking of which, I would like to show you at home something. It says something. Is something wrong? I broke something. Ah ha 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 ha. Okay. All right. This next performer, he's 16 years old. He lives in New Jersey. He's been doing magic now for many, many months. He's very cool and he's absolutely hysterical. Please put your hands together for Zizou.
Hola, my name is Zizou and I'm Z. Yeah, that's my nickname. I'm going to perform, yeah, metal bending. So, yeah, let's get started. So I have extraordinary spoon here from Walmart. Watch. Oh. It bent a little bit. Let's try one more time. Yep. Let's try something with fork. Okay, I have fork here. This time, you will bend it or twist it, whatever. Yes, you. Okay, watch here and think, twist, twist, twist. Yeah, that's it. Twisting. Pretty good. Okay, this time I will shake it and you say stop in your mind, okay? Say stop. Just make sure I'm not using my sleeves, okay? And let's try one more time. Say stop. Let's finish it. Yeah, that's it. My name is Lee, and thank you.
Well, I know next time I go to a restaurant, I'm never going to look at the silverware the same again. I'm gonna be wiggling in for whatever. All right. This next performer, he's actually our youngest SYMer at only 6 years old. He lives in the Upper East Side of New York City, and this is his second time performing at Kid Zone. He is our youngest member, and aside from magic, he loves karate, and he could probably beat me in chess. Please put your hands together for the amazing youngster, Daniel.
My name's Daniel. What's your name?
My name's Scott.
Nice to meet you, Scott.
Nice to meet you, Daniel.
Scott, do you want to see a trick I learned from a great magician called Doug Edwards?
Yes, I'd love to see it.
Okay, so here's how it goes. Okay. Pick a card, pick any card.
Okay. I have it.
Okay, show that to everybody out there, but don't show me. Done?
Yes.
Put it right back right here. I bury the card into the deck. No idea where your card is. Abracadabra helps them. There's one card face up. Is this your card?
The five? No, that's not my card.
That's great because I never said it was. It's the indicator card. It indicates that your card is five cards away. So one, two, three, four, and five is your card.
Yes, that's my card. Wow.
It also indicates. The four aces.
Wow.
That was truly incredible. All right, thank you, Daniel. It's so amazing to see our youngest member doing such amazing work. Actually, he's our youngest member. I mentioned before this is for the SYM, which stands for Society of Young Magicians. We're a national organization, and we run from ages 7 to 17, kids from all over the country who love and who have a passion for magic. And in many different states, there are many different chapters and assembly groups. And we meet on a monthly basis, and we discuss tricks. And now, we're doing magic for the Kids Zone. And we are so excited to represent the SYM. Now, this next performer, he's actually from Sparta, New Jersey. And at 11 years old, this is his first time performing in Kids Zone. He's now been doing magic for about a year now, and he's been into the SYM for 3 months now. So please, give it up for Tommy.
Hello, everybody. My name is Tommy, Tommy Kazakowicz, and today I will be introducing you to Mike the Coin. Now, Mike the Coin is a very special coin. He has a very special talent about him. First time I got him, I was about 5 years old. My dad took me to a coin shop in New York. And I put him in my left hand, and it was no use in having this coin because I already had a lot of half dollars, so I just threw him away. And I looked back, and I heard no sound. And I looked at my right hand, and it was right there. Now, I did it again. I opened my hand. It was my right hand. It was just so weird, because just think about it. You have a coin. You put it in your left hand, all right? Just say. Just have an imaginary coin. Pretend to place it in your left hand. Look back, and it's just gone. And you look in your right hand, it's right there. It is very, very strange to have a coin like this, but also very lucky because I would have never found this coin if my dad never took me to New York, the coin shop. But it's a pretty cool coin. I mean, look at that. So amazing, but very utterly annoying. So that's really it. Thank you for having me on stage. Good to see you next year.
That was great. Thanks so much, Tommy. Wow. Is there something between us? I dropped something. I stepped in something. Okay. You want more? Okay. I'm sorry. I do these for the cheap laughs. Now, our next performer, he's also 11 years old, he lives in Brooklyn, and much like regular people, he hates homework. You'll soon learn more about that later. Please give it up for the amazing Tate Richardson. Take it away, Tate.
Hi, my name's Tate, I'm 11 years old, like you just said, and I hate homework. And you see, I'm very bad at math, and my teacher a lot of times gives me extra math homework. So instead of doing magic today, I thought you might be able to help me with some of that. Homework. Yeah, you see, when I keep it in my lunchbox, it makes my homework smell just like what I had for lunch today. It's beautiful. Here, can I have a volunteer just come on up? What's your name?
I'm Robert.
So a big round of applause for Robert. Now, Robert, I have a little math packet that my teacher gave me, and I want you just to open that up and read aloud the first problem. Or the first step.
One, take the three equal ropes.
Equal, huh? Here, let's try something. Just take the one, the two, the three ropes. Here, read the second question.
Subtraction, take one away. How many do you have left?
I'd have two left, huh? All right.
Take one more away. How many do you have left?
I would have... I would have one left. Here. Final answer. Next question, yeah.
Attach both ends to make a circle.
Works. All right. Well, I guess I'll have to put them back. Okay. Next question.
Engineering. Cut the rope.
Actually, I don't have any scissors, so can you just go like that and just cut the rope right there? That's great. Thanks. And final question.
Do long division with remainders.
Doesn't say a problem. All right. I just do that. So a bit long division with one final remainder. Okay. That's it all, ladies and gentlemen. Thank you very much. My name's Tate. I hope you enjoy the rest of the show. Good night, or good afternoon, or have a good day.
Wow. That was a great job, Tate. I have to say, though, it was a wonderful job, but I couldn't help but notice that you also had a vest. I thought I would be the only one. I feel like a girl at prom right now. It's okay. I got my vest for free, though, so I think we all know who got the better deal here. Now, our next performer, he's actually 14 years old. He's been doing magic since he was 3. He wasted the first 2 years of his life. He hails from the far land of Scarsdale, New York. Ooh. And aside from magic, he enjoys swimming. So please put your hands together, take them apart, put them back together, and do that a few more times for David Calamari. David.
Hello, everyone. My name is David Calamari, as David just said. Thank you. And yes, that is like the seafood. Today, I would like to show you guys something a little bit strange. I'm not sure if you have ever seen this before, but this is an invisible coin purse. Now, despite the name, it does hold other things besides coins. You might actually be able to hear. No, you can't really hear it, but you sure can see it. You see, there's a marker. And there's also a, there is actually a coin. Now, I am actually going to need a volunteer for this, so you, sir, can you please come up? Everyone give him a nice round of applause. What's your name?
Alex.
Alex, David. Please take a seat. Fantastic. Now, as I was saying, this coin purse is kind of strange. Whatever you take out of it, you can see it on the outside, but when you put it on the inside, you can't see it. But then when you take it back out again, you can. The only exception is if I hold the coin purse just like this and place it right there in the bottom of the purse, then you can see it there, right?
Okay.
Yes, you can see it. So go ahead, please pull that out and place it on the table. Thank you. Now, most people do usually go for the bigger one, but that's okay. We can work with this. We'll work with the... We have a marker and a coin. That's it. A marker and, okay. I guess we only have the coin. So everybody, keep your eyes on the marker. You know what? It's okay. I'm a professional. I always carry an extra one. Fantastic. So let's just try this again, okay? So we'll place the marker aside just for a moment so you can focus your attention on the coin, and we'll use the marker as kind of a makeshift magic wand to make the coin disappear. Thank you. Yet somehow, the coin actually appears in the cap of the marker. This doesn't make any sense. You know what, let's try this again. But this time, just keep your attention on the coin because sometimes he likes to change places with the marker. It's kind of strange. Let's make this even less complex and eliminate the confusion by just getting rid of the coin completely so you can just focus on the marker. Watch, one, two. Oh. So there's the coin, meaning in the pocket is the marker. Thank you. So we'll take the marker, we'll place it aside, and we'll change the coin into the marker. Now let's change things up a little bit and actually have the coin jump under the arm. So now that we have the coin over here, we can use it, to make the... Now, before I leave, I want to actually show you one last thing. We'll do a card trick. Why not? So I have a deck of cards. And here's what we're going to do. Alex, can you just hold your hands out like this? Perfect. We have a deck of cards.
Yes.
Most magicians would not do this. In fact, none that I know of actually do this. But I'm going to shuffle the cards face up into face down, being the daring person that I am. That's right, face up, face down, face up, face down, face up, face down, and so on and so forth. Now, if I kept doing it in your hands like that, that would take a long time, let's face it. So I'll just speed things up a little bit and shuffle them together just like this. just to make things go a little bit quicker. Fantastic. And just keep your hands like that. Perfect, just like that. And I'm going to try and find the four aces in this crazy shuffle deck of cards. So here we go. It just takes a couple cuts and some sensitive fingers, and there's hopefully the first ace. Now this is called dead cutting. It's kind of strange because you cut right to hopefully the second ace, the ace of hearts. Now, have you ever been to Las Vegas?
No.
No, you have not. Well, I was just there this last summer, and they don't, obviously I'm too young to go into the casinos, but I'm able to walk around and see what's going on. Now, cheaters, they would get kicked out for doing this, but they do something called the center deal by dealing the card out of the center of the deck. It's cheating, but that's the third ace. Now, take a look at those cards, and would you tell me which ace is missing?
We are missing the ace of clubs, or spades, excuse me.
Ace of spades. Okay, perfect. So there's cards that are face up, face up, face up, face down, and more face up because of the way we shuffled them before. Remember all that craziness? But if I just snap my fingers, you'll notice that every single card, all the cards go back to normal except for just one card only. Alex, before we pull that card out, what card do you think that is?
The ace of spades.
Let's take a look. Go ahead, pull it out and show it to the camera and everybody else.
The ace of spades.
Ace of spades. Thank you. And would you just keep your, hold out your hands like that and just hold on to those. Now, I'm not allowed to have cards in school. I'm sure a lot of other schools have similar rules like that because they think we're gambling. But I was doing this trick in school, actually, and my friend asked me, can you do this with my deck of cards? And I said, yes, I can actually do it with any deck of cards that someone gives me. In fact, I can do it with any deck of cards that I've ever used, because you'll see that every single card in the entire deck, every single one completely changed, every single one, including the ones in your hand. Go ahead, flip them over and show them. Thank you so much. My name is David Calamari. I hope you enjoy the rest of the show.
Wow, incredible job, David. I know next time I see you, I'm going to give you my deck of cards for you to do. All right. I'd actually like to show you something a little different. It's a rope trick, another rope trick. I know, but this one's different, I promise. Watch. I have here an ordinary white piece of rope. I used to do this trick with two white pieces of rope, but you'll see why in a second why I don't anymore. You see, if I take this piece of rope, I'm going to make a little loop, just like this. For all you Boy Scouts in the audience, you'll know that by tying this loop and by stretching this, do you know what this is? Some of you may have said a knot. It is a knot, but to be more specific, it is an amazing acrobatic knot. That was perfect. Now, this isn't just a regular knot, because you see, it can do things regular knots can't. I have a red rope for contrast here. I'm going to take the knot, and I want you to watch as it jumps ropes. All I have to do is I swirl it around. I give it a little swirl, just like this, in the holiday spirit, a candy cane. Watch. If I give it a little blow and I say the magic words, which are very secret, you cannot hear it. Just like that, you'll see the knot actually jumps onto the other rope. Can you see why this didn't work before when I had two pieces of white rope? Here we go. Now, a lot of people say, oh, I know how that's done. It's not actually an acrobatic knot. Well, they're wrong. It is an acrobatic knot. I'll show you. I'll prove it. Look, I'll even do it in front of your eyes. You'll see it. Watch the knot. Ah. Ah. Yeah, just like that. The knot actually jumps off the rope. But that's the hard part. The easy part is getting it back on. That's a piece of cake. Now, this is weird. Because look, if I actually reach into my pocket, I can pull out a little bit of sprinkle, some magic dust, poof, just like that. I'm going to sprinkle a little more, poof, and one more. Poof, because that's really fun.
Now, if I take this knot, all I have to do is if I focus enough and I look at it and I stare at it hard enough, I can make the knot actually slide from one end of the rope to the other. You see, now it's on this end of the rope, and now it's on this end. And the rope, Okay. See, that's the effect of this magic dust. But if I take the magic dust from the other pocket, ooh, now it gets a little crazy. Watch this. See that? Now it doesn't slide anymore, but if I blow, the knot actually fuses onto the rope. Alrighty. Our next performer, his name, you'll learn in the end. He's 12 years old. He's been in the SYM for 3 years now. He lives in Manhattan, and just like most kids his age, he loves video games. Please give him a round of applause. His name is Evan Wagner.
Hello, everybody. My name is Evan Wagner. David just said. I'm so sorry about this. I've got a briefcase here. I'll explain a little bit about that later. But I'm so sorry. I'm so unprepared for this. I'm so sorry. I came in this. I'm looking so messy. I'm sorry about that. Let's see what I can do. Ah, that's a lot better. Hello? So, yeah. I was walking down the street, and I went and had this briefcase. I went and saw a briefcase. Someone threw it away. And I don't know why someone would throw a briefcase this nice away. It's a really nice briefcase, made of leather. So it has a 6-code lock. So people from the audience just shout out some numbers.
4.
Another?
7.
2. 2.
3.
3.
8.
8. One more?
6.
6. So that's 3, 8, 6, 5, 4, 8. I like that number. Let's see. Did you look at that? What the? Huh. Someone put in. Why would they put an empty tube? I really don't know why someone really put in an empty tube. I don't really get why someone put an empty tube. It makes no sense. Hey, wait a minute. What's this? God, someone keeps putting empty stuff here. What is it with empty stuff? Huh. Wait. Wasn't there just a second ago? Wait, but I'm one of those people that likes the contrast of things. These two colors, they don't really match. So I'll just put them back in. Snap my fingers, shake it under my leg. Sometimes I gotta do it behind the back, again under the leg, under the other leg. Then turns black. And wait, no. Forget this. This doesn't make any sense. What is this doing in here? Ew, that's really strange. For a second I thought this was a cane. Whoa, oh my. Wow. It's really weird. Hey, wait a minute. How did this get in here? Hey, where'd it go? That's weird. Well, anyways, if you enjoyed this show, my name's Evan Wagner. If you didn't, my name's Chris Angel.
And I will definitely be calling you Evan Wagner. Wasn't that was I don't know why someone would put all that in the case. Now, for one final thing, I would like to show you something weird with a dollar bill. Because you see, if I were to get change for a dollar, most of the time I would get coins. What kind of coins? No one has half dollars lying around, and most people aren't going to give me 100 pennies. So I'd most likely get 4 quarters. Now, what I'm going to do is I'm actually going to change this dollar bill into 4 quarters. You may not believe me, but if I tell you, it's already done. You see, look, you see on this side, it may look like the dollar bill is still intact. And it is still a dollar bill, but it isn't 4 quarters. Not like the coins, but actually the bill itself, it's actually melted and the borders have decided to go through the middle. That's what I call a mismade dollar bill. Now, unfortunately, we are down to our last performer, but he's definitely something worth waiting for. He's been in the SYM now for many, many years. He was actually a previous president of the Society of Young Magicians. He lives in Manhattan. Wonderful kid. Please, put your hands together for the amazing Adam Kravlin.
How's everyone doing? I hope you guys are enjoying the show. I am the last performer. My name is Adam Kravlin, and I love magic. And I thought I'd do something right here. As you can see, it's actually invisible. But if you take the invisible particles, bring it up, and put them together, and place it, oh, it's a deck of cards. Pretty weird. We're gonna do a card trick. I love card tricks. Someone in the front, right there, in the front row, can you please say stop as I go through the cards, all right?
Stop.
Right there. Let's see what card you got. The King of Hearts, a pretty good card, the King of Hearts. But you know what's better than one king? All four. What? All four kings. Now, that's all we need. All we need is the four kings. Because we're going to see how well you guys know your cards, all right? All right, let's see. All right, I'll show you the first card, the King of Clubs. The King of Clubs is the first card. The second card is the King of Spades. So we have the King of Clubs and the King of Spades, which means I have the King of Hearts and the King of Diamonds. Exactly. Now watch. Because you see, now I have the King of Clubs and the King of Spades, which means now on the table is the King of Hearts and the King of Diamonds. Thank you. Now we're going to try one more thing, one last thing. I'm going to take the four kings and place them into my pocket, which means watch very closely. Watch. Watch the deck of cards. Watch every single card very closely. You'll see it happen. Because you see, they melt down into the four kings. They melt into the four kings, which now means inside my pocket is the entire deck of cards. Thank you so much. My name's Adam Kravlin. I hope you enjoyed the show. Thank you.
Now that is what I call a grand finale. And with the grand finale, the show must come to an end. My name is David Rosenstein, representing the Society of Young Magicians, Assembly Number 69. Have a great day, everybody.